Now our job is to write the equation of a line that passes through two given points. And we are to do it first in point-slope form, in slope-intercept form, and then in standard form. Again, this process of starting with slope, point-slope form, moving to slope-intercept to standard, is a very common practice, and point-slope form always seems to be the place that you start. So let's begin there. So in order to use the point-slope form, we need a point, and we need the slope. So let's pick, we can just pick one of these points. It doesn't matter which one, for sake of argument. Let's pick this first point as our point for point-slope form. And then next we'll need the slope from these two points. Let's use the slope formula. Again, if that formula isn't in your notes yet, I would recommend you write it in. So we'll want y2 minus y1. So let's take y2 minus y1, and we'll divide that by x2 minus x1. And that fraction, of course, will simplify to negative 2. So now we have our slope. So we have our slope of negative 2, and we have a point. So all that's left to do is to substitute the values into the point-slope form. And then lastly, we can simplify the left side. We have y minus negative 4. Of course, when you subtract the negative, that's positive. So final answer, y plus 4 is equal to negative 2 times the quantity x minus 2. Next, we want the same line, but we want that line in slope-intercept form. So we'll use point-slope form to get to slope-intercept. So we'll want to take our point-slope form and, using algebra, isolate the y and have the right side equal to mx plus b. So first, let's use the distributive property on the right side. Next, we'll subtract 4 from both sides, which leaves us with y is equal to negative 2x plus 0. And so y equals negative 2x is our slope-intercept form. In this case, the y-intercept is 0, 0. Lastly, to put this equation into standard form, we'll use the previous slope-intercept form, and using algebra, we'll get it into standard form. First, remind yourself, standard form. And so we have the equation y equals negative 2x, and we want the y's and the x's to be on the same sides of the equation, so we'll add 2x to both sides. So we have 2x plus y is equal to 0. And now that's fair game, even though it doesn't look like a, b, and c. Well, c is 0 right now, but 0 is an integer, and so now we're all done. This example is finished. We had an equation in point-slope form. We had the same equation in slope-intercept form. And lastly, we had the equation in standard form.